Our next inductee spent a lifetime helping the youth of our community, Carlton J. Gaffney. Carl was the Southern Tier Athletic Conference Executive Director from his formation back in 1966 till he retired in 2013. Served as Binghamton Parks and Recreation, softball, basketball, Little League Supervisor for 45 years, well, up to as many as 503 teams back in 1988. He also, from 1960 through 1999, served as the Officer of Local and District Commissioner of the New York State Amateur Softball Association. He directed 10 ASA softball tournaments at Conlon Field, bringing some of the best softball athletes to our area. As a student, Carl played baseball, basketball at Johnson City. In addition to baseball and basketball, he played soccer at Ithaca College while earning his BS and MS degrees there. He saw combat as a Marine in the Pacific in World War II, played briefly for a baseball team managed by legendary baseball Hall of Famer Bill Beck. He also attended umpiring school in Florida. He umpired in the minors from 1949 to 52, and from 1952 through 62 was a member of the Binghamton Umpires Association. He also taught over that span at East Junior Middle School. From 1962 through 86, he taught at Susquehanna Valley High School and became the first athletic director there. Also serving many years as high school basketball referee, won't you please welcome here tonight for the great honor of being inducted into the Greater Binghamton Shrine, Carlton J. Gaffney.
Soccer team or the golf team. And And as I went along, before I knew it, I'm ready to graduate from John City High School, and the draft was waiting. They didn't wait very long. They grabbed me in July of 1943. And somehow I went over to the West End Armory for the physical, and when I got over there, I got in the wrong line. And you know where I ended up. Before I knew it, I was down at the boot camp at Paris Island, and before you knew much longer, I was at Camp Lejeune. And before you knew it, I was training to do a couple of different things. And I was on my way to the South Pacific, where I spent a couple of years, and went up and down the slot in the South Pacific. And got a chance even to play some baseball, because we got a little time off when we were in sort of a rest camp in Guadalcanal, and I happened to play on the Italian baseball team. And the coach was a fellow named Bill Beck. He wrote a book called Beck is in a Wreck. And he was something else. At that time, his parents owned the Milwaukee team and the AAA there. So some of you remember there were people that he put up, like a midget he sent up to play once in St. Louis. And he dropped a few fireworks in a few other places. So we did play some baseball, and then we went on our way. Before we know it, we were back at Guam, and we were refitting, and we were getting ready, and we were penciled in that the 6th Marine Division, which I was in, was scheduled to go with about 20 other American divisions to push forward and make the major landing on Tokyo proper. I was working down in the hold of a ship, unloading the ship one day, in August of 1945, and the president was Harry Truman, and he decided to drop the bomb. And when he dropped the bomb, it only took a few days or a week or so, and Japan threw in the towel, and the war was over. I thought I might be coming home, but I'd only been in the South Pacific, and in the Marine Corps for about 25 months. So I didn't have enough points to come home. And so I had to continue my career. And before I knew it, in September of 1945, I was on a boat. There were a number of boats in the convoy. Our whole Marine Division had been refitted. We had new guns, we had new uniforms, we had new everything. And we had thousands of new troops to replace the people that were going home. But I wasn't going home, I was going to China. And I want to tell you a little bit about China. China was a city of about 2 million. When we got there, we went there to accept the Japanese surrender because they were in control in North China. And we had to get all spruced up. We got all our guns cleaned up, all our trucks, all our tanks, and we started in the parade down the main boulevard in the city of Tsingtao. It's not called Tsingtao, but they had to change the name. I can't remember the name. We marched down that street, and I'll tell you, the Chinese people were 10 deep along the sidewalks on both sides. They were cheering us. I've never heard cheering us before. I was so proud I was standing as tall as I could. I sure was 3 inches taller than when I started the march. And we marched all the way about 2 miles down to the racetrack where the Japanese people came out. They signed the papers. We signed the papers. And the next job, we were there to do that job. We had to collect the Japanese troops and make arrangements for them to go back to Japan. And we took over guarding North China. I was there about 3 or 4 months, guarding many different places. Finally, I got the time to come home. When I got home, there was a thing called the GI Bill. The GI Bill. Oh, some of you may not know this. Okay? The GI Bill was a magic thing. It was wonderful. I got 5 years of college, I got 2 degrees, got $7 a month, and I could go to college and play ball and learn how to be a referee. And when I got done, I was on my way to a field of education. It's a lot of teamwork at the college because I started refereeing there. And of course, referees have to work together and they're in a lot of trouble. So I did go on to my 10 years as a teacher at East Junior, where I picked up and Ann taught me so much. My mentor at East Junior was a man named Edson Wright. He had Ray Stanton in the Leaders Club. Ray Stanton is sitting here today. The Leaders Club had a lot of nice guys. And I sure appreciate all those guys that come up to me here today and mention their time in the Leaders Club at East Junior. I was there for 10 years, then I went on to Eschley. Eschley was a great place to go. They needed an athletic director, so I ended up at Eschley. My career was not over in the East Junior. I was on a lot of teams along the way. And they were not all good, but they were fine groups of people. So, I'd like to thank you all for coming today. You made my day. You made my career, and you made my life. I'll never forget it. Thank you.